Alright, so in this lesson, we are going to start the process of modeling the racetrack, so let's get started. To start off with, I'm going to create a box in the top viewport. The sizing is going to be length of 5, width of 100, and height of 10. I right click on the coordinate spinners to move it to the origin. I'll go back to my top viewport and make a copy of this by holding down shift on my keyboard. I'll convert one of these to an editable poly object. And then attach the second one. I'll center a pivot on these and then move them back to the origin. I'll modify the shape on the second one so they look a little bit more random. I'll go back to my top viewport and create a box. That's going to be our brick. I'm going to place it somewhere over here in the corner. The sizing is going to be height of 10. I'll align this up in my top viewport. I'll convert this to an editable poly object. I'll take this guy, shrink him in, and move him over. I'll go back to my top level, take this guy, and make a copy of this by holding down shift. I'll move the copy to the origin on the x-axis. And then attach the second one. I'll center a pivot on these and then move them to the origin again. I'll check this in my perspective viewport. So that's looking good. So I'll go back to my top viewport and now we're going to create the cylinder. That's going to be our pole. I'm going to draw it somewhere over here. The sizing is going to be radius of 1.5 and height of 80. I'll align this up in my side viewport. And I'm going to dial the number of height segments up to 30 because we are going to bend it so that it bends smoothly later on. So now, I'm going to go back to my left viewport and now we are going to apply a bend modifier on it. So the angle is going to be 120 and direction is going to be negative 90. And we are going to limit the effect, so I will say limit and dial the upper limit up. Since limiting is not enough, we are going to affect the center of the bend. And then I'll play around with the upper limit until I get the result that I like. I'll check this in my perspective viewport. So this is looking nice, so I'll collapse the stack and convert this to an editable poly object. As you can see, here there is extra resolution where we don't need it, so I'll hit delete on my keyboard, go to the border mode, take these guys and hold on shift and make a drag a copy down. That fixes the extra resolution, but here you can see the edges now are very blocky. So fix that. I'm going to select them in a polygon mode and go down and say auto smooth. I'll go back to my top level, and now you can see that fixes the extra resolution as well as the geometry. The object is very smooth. So now let's create the bracket that's going to hold on our wire onto our pole. For that, I'm going to the back viewport. Hit G on my keyboard to get rid of the grid, and hit F3 on my keyboard to get a smooth view. Now I'll draw out the bracket using a box primitive. I'll modify the shape in the perspective viewport. I'll move it back in place, and now I'll modify the shape until I get the result that I like. I'll line this up in my back viewport. I'll move it down. I'll go back to my side viewport, and now I'm going to create a tube that's going to be a part of our bracket. I'll convert this to a little poly object and then delete these extra guys over here which we don't need. I'll line this up in my side viewport, back viewport. Change the color so that we can differentiate between two of these. Let me check this in my perspective view. Here you can see there are extra edges where we don't need them, so I'll select them by holding down Control on my keyboard, say loop, and hit Control Backspace. I'll do the same thing on the inside. I'll select these guys, say loop, and hit Control Backspace. So now actually create the wire that's going to sit in our bracket. For that we are going to use a cylinder primitive. We don't want any cap segments. For the radius is going to be 0.3 and height is going to be 100. And we don't need that many height segment because we are not going to bend it, or so it's going to be smooth anyway. Actually we are going to bend them, so I'll dial the number of height segment back to 30. I'll center the pivot on this and then move it to the origin on the x-axis. I'll select three of these and make a couple of copies by holding down shift on my keyboard. And let's say I want 5 copies. I rotate this, move it, and line it up until I get the result that I like. I'll make another copy and place it over here, rotate it, move it, and line it up until I get a result that I like. Okay, let me check this in the perspective view.